Why is it so difficult to build a lunar base if there's already one in space? Human ingenuity and technology have managed to overcome challenges that centuries ago seemed unimaginable. Yet although we have already managed to get humans to the moon and build bases in space where astronauts can remain indefinitely outside our planet, we have not yet built a base on our natural satellite. So why is building a base on the moon so tricky if there is already one in space? Let's find out. Hey guys, have you ever heard of a VPN? If not, let me explain it to you in a way that's easy to understand. Browsing the internet without a VPN is like sending a private message to a group chat. Everyone can see what you're up to. Scary, right? But don't worry, I've got just the solution for you. Introducing Private Internet Access, or PIA for short. Watching Netflix without PIA is like going to Paris as a tourist but being only allowed to see the suburbs. But with PIA, you get access to region-restricted content from all over the world. PIA is like a bodyguard for your internet connection, protecting you from the prying eyes of hackers, internet service providers, and others that can view your personal data. Plus, it's the world's most transparent VPN provider, with over 30 million downloads. PIA never records or stores user data, and its no-logs policy has been proven multiple times in court and by a third-party audit from Deloitte. It's available for all platforms, Windows, macOS, Android, Linux, iOS, and many more. You can now use one private internet access subscription to protect an unlimited amount of devices at the same time. And get this, by using the link in the description, you can grab an 83% discount on private internet access. That's just $2.03 a month, and you can also get 4 extra months completely free. Signing up for private internet access is risk-free. There's a 30-day money-back guarantee, and 24/7 customer support is available. So why not try and see it for yourself? Sign up today and protect your digital life with private internet access. The exploration of space has been one of the most outstanding achievements of humanity since the launch of Sputnik 1 on October 4, 1957. We have made great strides in space exploration, both in spacecraft and in construction, to maintain a permanent settlement of humans in space with space stations. There are currently two space stations in operation, the Tiangong Space Station, built by the China National Space Administration, CNSA, and the International Space Station, abbreviated as ISS for its acronym, which was built in collaboration with 5 space agencies from different countries, NASA, the United States, Roscosmos, Russia, JAXA, Japan, ESA, Europe, and CSA, ASC, Canada. But despite significant achievements in space, building a lunar base has been an elusive goal. One of the main reasons behind this difficulty is the lack of resources and the technical complexity of establishing a permanent settlement in a resourceless place like the moon. Why was it easier to build a space station than a base on the moon? The International Space Station, ISS, is a complex space project involving the collaboration of multiple space agencies and countries. Construction of the ISS began in 1998 and was completed in 2011, becoming the most prominent artificial structure in space. Despite the technical and logistical challenges, building the ISS was less complicated than trying to build a space base on the lunar surface for several reasons. First, the ISS is in orbit around the Earth, meaning it is not exposed to gravity and the extreme environmental conditions of the lunar surface. Building in space allows for greater flexibility and freedom of movement, making it easier to work on the space station and adjust its design and construction. Second, the ISS was built on a series of missions that involved delivering individual parts and modules to the space station. This allowed the construction of the ISS to be carried out incrementally rather than building an entire structure from scratch in one place, as could be the case with a lunar base. The ISS is in orbit around the Earth, which means it doesn't have to deal with Earth's atmosphere. Plus, it's orbiting at a distance of 400 kilometers, making it relatively fast to send supplies and personnel back and forth to the station. On the moon, gravity is 6 times less than Earth's, meaning any structure must be anchored very well to the surface. Otherwise, it would not be stable enough. In addition, the moon lacks an atmosphere, which means there is no protection from solar radiation, micrometeorites, and cosmic rays. These factors make building a lunar base much more complex than building a space station. Finally, the construction of the ISS was carried out in collaboration with several countries and space agencies, which allowed for the sharing of the workload and costs of the project. In the case of a lunar base, construction and maintenance would be the responsibility of a single space agency, requiring a significant investment in time and resources. The main problems that hinder the construction of a lunar base are many. Some of them are 1. Lunar gravity. The moon has much lower gravity than Earth's, only about 17% of Earth's gravity. This means any structure built on the moon must withstand different loads. Engineers must design structures that can withstand lunar gravity, but they must also consider the effect of gravity on the construction and operation of the base. The gravity of the moon also affects the way structures are built, since they must be stronger and more stable than those built on Earth, because the center of gravity of the construction will be different. Not to mention how difficult it would be for astronauts to adapt to life on the moon. Remember how the astronauts of the Apollo missions moved on the moon, making small jumps? This is because, on the one hand, the suits they wore were not very ergonomic. On the other, the body center of gravity was not the same as on Earth. On Earth, we can maintain balance and walk because our brain knows where the center of gravity is. And based on that, we balance our weight to walk. But on the moon, this center of gravity changes. So our brain must get used to locating that point in our body. If we want astronauts to stay longer on the moon, they will have to adapt to walking in a place with low gravity. In a way, it would be like relearning to walk. In addition, low gravity also hinders the construction process, as building materials must be transported from Earth and then installed on the moon. Number 2. Regolith. Regolith is a dust found all over the lunar surface. This is formed due to meteorite impacts and the solar wind. One of the main problems presented by all missions to the moon is due to this material. Regolith is not like dust from the Earth. It is very small, meaning that dust particles are tiny and can get anywhere, seriously affecting electrical systems, clogging air ducts, and causing severe failures in pipes and systems responsible for air and water purification. When the astronauts of the Apollo missions walked on the lunar surface and returned to the control modules, the regolith spread throughout the module, getting into every corner of the ship when removing the suit. Some astronauts also mentioned that this regolith smelled of sulfur and was very difficult to remove because it is so tiny that no damp cloth cleans it. It wasn't until they reached Earth that engineers took it upon themselves to get rid of this material in the suits used to walk on the moon. Still, even they had difficulty, as lunar dust particles are tiny and easily stick to anything. Before sending astronauts to the moon, the problem with regolith will have to be solved, because if it remains in the habitat of humans, it could cause long-term health problems in astronauts, since it would get into the air and water ducts. Number 3. The lack of atmosphere. The moon has no significant atmosphere, which means there is no protection from solar radiation, micrometeorites, and cosmic rays. Solar radiation can damage electronic equipment and affect the health of astronauts. Micrometeorites are small objects that impact at high speed on the lunar surface and can damage the structures of the lunar base. Cosmic rays are charged high-energy particles that can damage living tissue and affect the health of astronauts. This also means that there is no air to breathe on the moon. Astronauts would have to carry their source of oxygen. In addition, the lack of an atmosphere also makes it difficult to control the temperature at the lunar base. Without an atmosphere to retain heat, the temperature on the moon can vary significantly during the day and night. The cost of construction. Building a lunar base is very expensive due to the technical complexity and lack of existing infrastructure on the moon. Building materials must be transported from Earth, which significantly increases the cost of construction. In addition, building a lunar base would require complete supporting infrastructure, including power generation, water and air supply, waste disposal, and communication with Earth. Building a lunar base would also require the formation of a specialized team of astronauts and scientists. These experts would have to work in extreme conditions on the moon and be able to solve complex technical problems in the field. Who would venture into this dangerous and costly mission? Whoever dared to do it would have to be paid well, since the astronauts in charge of building the lunar base would put their lives at risk. Since any failure or error, both in the life support systems of the suits, as well as radiation sickness and regolith, could be fatal. Would you like to be part of the astronauts who build the lunar base, even with the risks this implies? Let us know your opinion in the comments. Number 4. Lack of water. Unlike Earth, the Moon does not have a dense atmosphere that retains water in liquid form, and there are no bodies of liquid water on its surface. However, water is essential for human life and survival on a lunar base. But there is no water on the Moon. We'll talk about that in a moment. How to overcome all obstacles? Number 1. Solutions for lunar gravity. One of the solutions to lunar gravity is to design structures that can withstand different loads than they would on Earth. Engineers must consider lunar gravity at all stages of construction, from planning to installation. In addition, unique materials can be used to build more robust and more stable structures, such as carbon fiber, Kevlar, and other composite materials that are never used on Earth, but on the Moon could be an option. Another solution for lunar gravity is 3D printing on the Moon. This technology allows the on-site fabrication of components and structures using local lunar materials. 3D printing also reduces the amount of material that needs to be transported from Earth, which reduces construction costs. Number 2. Solutions for the lack of atmosphere. A solution for the lack of atmosphere is the use of inflatable structures. These structures provide an additional layer of protection from solar radiation and micrometeorites, and can be deployed on the Moon after landing. In addition, these structures can also be used as housing for astronauts and are relatively easy to make, in addition to weighing little and therefore would be easy to transport from Earth. Another solution to the lack of atmosphere is the generation of oxygen and water from the Moon's local resources. The technology of extracting water from the Moon is currently being developed. This would allow astronauts to produce drinking water and oxygen to breathe directly on the Moon, creating an atmosphere throughout the natural satellite. However, this process has its complications, since the lunar gravity is so low that it is unknown if it could retain a hypothetical artificial atmosphere. Number 3. Construction cost solutions. One solution to the construction cost is using reusable rockets to transport materials and supplies from Earth to the Moon. This would significantly reduce construction costs and allow for more missions to the Moon. Another solution for the cost of construction is an international collaboration. Building a lunar base is expensive and complex, and collaboration between countries and organizations can help reduce costs and speed up the construction process. Collaboration can also allow the combining of resources and expertise to address the technical and scientific challenges of building a lunar base. If we find a way to use the same resources that the Moon has, the construction of the base would be much faster, cheaper, and more efficient, since it would not depend on a constant sending of resources from Earth. On the contrary, it would be best for the resources of the Moon to be sent to Earth to finance the entire construction of the lunar base. On the Moon, there are many materials that are in high demand in the technology industry, and that could even increase the need to build a lunar base shortly. Number 4. Solutions to the lack of water. One possible solution for the lack of water on the Moon is extracting water from lunar ice. Large deposits of water ice are thought to exist at the Moon's poles in permanently shadowed craters where the temperature is low enough for the ice not to evaporate. Extracting this water ice could provide an essential water source for future inhabitants of the Moon. Extracting the water from lunar ice would require advanced drilling and excavation technology. Transporting the necessary equipment and machinery to the Moon would also be necessary. Once the ice is extracted, it must be melted and purified to make it suitable for human consumption. Another possibility is the production of water through the reaction of hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen can be obtained from sunlight through the electrolysis of water or hydrogen production from reducing iron oxides with hydrogen. Luckily, the lunar regolith contains significant oxygen concentrations. We must extract it from rocks and dust. The lack of water on the moon is a significant problem, but potential solutions have been identified to address this challenge. Extracting water from lunar ice and producing water through the reaction of hydrogen and oxygen are two possible solutions that could provide a vital water source for future inhabitants of the moon. Building a lunar base is a significant technological and logistical challenge, but it is also an opportunity for human exploration and the advancement of science. The possibility of establishing a permanent human presence on the moon brings us one step closer to understanding our place in the universe and making great discoveries. The moon is an essential target for space exploration, not only for its scientific value, but also for its potential to serve as a base of operations for missions further away in the solar system. Thanks to this, it could also open the door to exploiting lunar resources and establishing a lunar economy. This exciting and ambitious project requires the collaboration and effort of space agencies worldwide. It has the potential to take us to new heights and expand our horizons in space exploration. What discoveries and achievements await us as we get closer and closer to the conquest of space? When do you think we could build the first base on the moon? Let us know your opinion with your valuable comment.